is up, you guys? Welcome back to another one. If you're new to the channel, I am Gold Pony. I do car, truck, SUV reviews on YouTube. Today, we are in the new 2020 Nissan Maxima, courtesy of Faulkner Nissan in Mechanicsburg, PA. I can tell you guys right off the bat, the exterior looks on this one, they're absolutely amazing. I know my wife absolutely loves the looks of the Maxima as well. And not only that, it's got above average reliability rating by Consumer Reports, so that's also a plus to get started too. So, what do you say? Let's just go ahead and jump right into it. And as always, let's start with pricing. It said there will actually be several different trim levels for the 2020 Maxima. First one being the S, starting at $34,250. Then you have the SV for $36,450. SL, which actually is the one we are in today, starting at $38,640. SR for $41,450. Platinum, starting at $41,640. And lastly, the Platinum Reserve, starting at $42,780. So like I said, tons of trim levels, so you can imagine there is something for everybody with the Maxima. But regardless of trim level that you go with, the power plant on this one will be the same. Powering the 2020 Maxima will be a 3.5 liter naturally aspirated V6, putting out 300 horsepower at 6,400 RPM, 261 pound-feet of torque available at 4,400 RPM, power sent to the front wheels through a CVT with paddle shifters for the SR trim level only, meaning the trim we have today does not have them, so we won't be testing those out. But nonetheless, 0 to 60 time comes in at approximately 5.7 seconds, with MPG numbers coming in at 20 in the city, 30 on the highway. That 30 highway MPG number is quite impressive, honestly, for a 300 horsepower sedan, so that's kind of cool. But anyways, in case you were interested, this one does take regular unleaded fuel, aka 87 octane, save you a little bit of money there, so that's always a plus. But before we do any kind of accelerations in the Maxima, I did want to mention to you guys, behind the shifter, there is a sport mode. There essentially are two driving modes, normal and sport. Sport, once you press that, it is immediately going to downshift for you, holding RPMs at a much higher level. It's also going to adjust the throttle response and the steering sensitivity as well. And I can definitely tell a noticeable weightier steering feel to this one when you do put it in that sport driving mode. So that is definitely a plus. But I think you guys know what time it is now. Let's go ahead and do a quick little acceleration test here in our Maxima. Let's find a straightaway and let's see how quickly we can get this one here up to speed. All right, you guys, and here we go. Wow. Oh my goodness. Did not remember this. Oh my goodness. Oh my god, I haven't hit the acceleration in the Maxima in quite a while, and honestly, I was kind of bracing myself for a good bit of spinach with all that power being sent to the front wheels, but it actually connected fairly well to the road, very well actually. So quite a very impressive acceleration. You can feel it in the pit of your stomach, and you gotta love that. So I almost wondered at first if this car needed all-wheel drive, and it would be kind of cool if it had an optional all-wheel drive system, especially since I'm in Pennsylvania. But still, even with the front-wheel drive configuration that comes with the Maxima, it definitely does very well. But so anyways, to go along with that acceleration, as always, braking is equally important. And so up front, you will find 12.6 inch ventilated front discs, and the back 12.1 inch ventilated rear disc. As far as the braking feel goes, it's been absolutely perfect for me so far today. There's no brake pedal delay on the Maxima, so that's definitely a good thing. Touching on suspension and handling, up front you're going to get an independent McPherson strut front suspension, in the back independent multi-link rear suspension, along with front and rear stabilizer bars. And I did want to mention, in addition to that, the SR trim level is actually going to give you a sport tuned suspension, meaning retuned dampers, stiffer springs, and a larger front stabilizer bar as well. But we don't have that trim today. But overall, the steering feel, especially in sport driving mode, it's brilliant. I love the steering feel in that sport driving mode in the Maxima, so that is wonderful. And if you didn't want that heavier steering feel, honestly, just take it out of sport driving mode and you'll be fine. So really, there's something for everybody there. As far as the ride quality goes, it's been actually just fine for me so far today, so definitely no issues with the ride quality. And touching on cabin noise, really all you get is a little bit of engine noise from the 3.5 liter V6, but honestly, in my opinion, that's a good thing. I like engine noise, and that's really only when you hit the gas. When you're just cruising like this, there isn't a whole lot of exterior noises coming into the cabin, so definitely a plus there as well. Touching on visibility a little bit, it's honestly perfectly fine. Typically, you're not gonna have any issues with sedans when it comes to visibility anyway, so I can see perfectly fine out the back. I did wanna also mention, along the lines of visibility, there are rain sensing windshield wipers that actually come standard on every trim level of the Maxima, meaning when the Maxima starts to detect rainfall, it's going to automatically turn on those windshield wipers. So one less thing you have to worry about, so you can better enjoy the drive. And it is an enjoyable drive here in the Maxima, so that is definitely a plus as well. But that about rounds out the performance segment of this review. Let's now go ahead and take a look at the exterior of this beautiful 2020 Nissan Maxima. All right, you guys, here she is, the 2020 Nissan Maxima. Definitely a good looking car in my opinion, but let's go ahead and start up front here. LED headlights coming standard across the board for all trim levels. And they do of course come with that automatic feature, meaning when it starts to get dark out at night, they will turn on automatically for you there. One less thing you have to worry about. LED signature daytime running lights also coming standard for all trim levels. And of course, you will get LED fog lights if you were to go with the SR trim level and up. Therefore, we do not have those today. So they are going to be kind of cool looking too. But let's go ahead and make our way to the side on this one. Chrome belt line molding coming standard. Chrome door handles also coming standard. Gloss black A-pillars. That is something that definitely distinguishes the Maxima from some of its other competitors out there. Also, gloss black floating roof line in the back. So ties together quite well in my opinion. And since Nissan was going with that gloss black theme, I should also mention power adjustable gloss black side mirrors will come standard across the board. They will be heated with LED integrated turn signals for the SL trim level and up, and you will get that reverse tilt down feature if you were to go with the SR trim level and up, meaning when you do put the vehicle in reverse, mirrors are going to tilt down so you're less likely to run anything over, so that's always a plus. But take a look down at the wheel setup. 18 by 8 inch aluminum alloy wheels coming with the SS V and SL, therefore you are looking at those right now. 19 by 8.5 inch aluminum alloys for the SR, and you will get a slightly different design but still 18 by 8 inch aluminum alloys for the Platinum and Platinum Reserve trim levels. So did want to mention that as well. But now let's go ahead and make our way to the back. Gloss black shark fin ish looking antenna up top there. Of course it's gloss black. Did want to mention there is a gloss black rear spoiler that comes standard with the SR trim level only. Otherwise there is no rear spoiler on the back of that trunk lid. LED tail lights coming standard across the board. Very cool looking design. I'm going to zoom up here kind of close for you. I just like all the detail work in those tail lights. It looks so good back there. But anyways, just below it all, dual exhaust outlets with chrome tips. So I do think you guys know what we have to do next. As always, here is that exhaust clip. So now since we are around back, when it comes to opening that rear trunk, there actually is a button on the key fob. Simply hold that down if you like. Also a button by the driver's side left knee, and there's a button on the trunk itself as well. So any of those three ways you can go about opening this one up. Once opened up, cargo capacity is going to come in at 14.3 cubic feet. If that was not enough space, there is a 60-40 split, meaning the rear seats do fold down for quite a bit of extra space there if you needed it. Then make your way to the rear legroom. That is going to come in at 34.2 inches. So by the numbers, it does sound a little bit on the smaller side of things, but for reference, I'm even 6 feet tall. This is how much space I have back there. Also for those rear passengers, I wanted to mention there is rear ventilation that comes standard for every single trim level. Also rear center armrest with cup holders, once again coming standard for all trim levels. And if you went with the Platinum Reserve trim level, actually you can get heated rear seats back there as well. So that is definitely quite nice. Make our way to the front seats. Cloth seating comes with the S trim level, leather seating with the SV trim level and up. And if you wanted that diamond quilted leather seating that you quite often see in Maximas, go with the SR trim level and up. That's how you're gonna get that. 8-way power adjustable driver seat with the S, and that comes with power lumbar if you go with the SV trim level and up. 4-way power adjustable passenger seat for all trim levels, memory settings for the SR and up, heated front seats for the SV trim level and up, that's always a big one, and heated and ventilated front seats if you were to go with the SR trim level and up. So taking a look now at the steering wheel, it is tilt and telescoping, it is leather wrapped for all trims and heated for the SL trim level and up. And also I did want to mention with the steering wheel, you will get Alcantara inserts if you were to go with SR trim level only, a little sportier type of feel to it there. Now let's go ahead and make our way to the startup. Let me first start by showing you guys the key. All of the buttons are actually located all on one side of the key. You have your Nissan logo at the very top. Lock, unlock button to pop the rear hatch. That little circular button at the top just below the Nissan logo, that is your remote start, which is actually going to come standard across the board. Every single trim level is going to get you that remote start, which means you get to warm up the Maxima on a cold day, so less likely to freeze to death when you first get inside, so that's always a plus. But also standard across the board though, push button start located just in front of the shifter there. So all I'm going to do here, simply put my foot on the brake and press that engine start button there. It's open then once started up. Tachometer is all the way to the left, speedometer is to the right. There is a fairly decent sized digital display front and center there. To control what is on that digital display, simply use the steering wheel mounted controls on the left side of the steering wheel there. It's going to give you a ton of different information, like of course trip A, trip B obviously, but average miles per gallon. It's going to give you your speed limit of any given road. There's a digital speedometer located up there as well. It's probably what I would leave it on. It's of course when you need your next oil change. There's a bunch of stuff honestly you can check out up there. And make our way to overall interior quality, a dual panel panoramic moonroof coming with the SL trim level and up, meaning both the front passengers and the rear passengers get their own individual moonroofs. That is pretty cool, and that's what you're looking at right now. Of course, dual zone climate control coming standard for all trim levels across the board. HomeLink controls, meaning your garage door openers for up to 3 different garage doors found on the rear view mirror here. And that, by the way, is going to come with the SL trim level and up. Therefore, we do have those today. That's always a plus because the alternative is the rattling garage door opener you put on your sun visor, which of course rattles at high speeds on the highway. So it's nice having HomeLink controls. Ambient LED lighting also with the SL trim level and up. There's a bunch of satin chrome interior trim throughout this one. Maple wood interior trim with the platinum trim level and up. You will find a charcoal headliner with the SR, and that also gives you aluminum foot pedals with that SR trim level too. But overall, a very nice finish honestly to the Maxima. You know, one of the things that I love about this one is just above the passenger side glove box and that silver trim, you actually have stitched leather up here, and also just above the gauges, more stitched leather as well. So a very high-end finish there. Just below the climate control is where you're going to find your hookups, basically USB charging port, phone charging port, auxiliary port, stuff like that. Just behind that, you got your dual cup holders and your heated seat buttons and all that fun stuff. And underneath the center armrest, you're going to have a 12 volt power outlet, as well as a pen/pencil holder and a ton of space you could store things in. So that is always a plus. Perhaps the only thing I would say room for improvement wise, as far as interior quality goes, is the silver trim around the shifter and the push button start and all that. I think that is probably going to get dirty and scratched up, maybe a little bit easier than some other finishes they could have put there. But still, other than that, it's definitely a very high-end finish, so no problems for me there. And so, but now let's take a look at the tech display. And one of the first things I noticed, just like the Nissan GTR, it is tilted slightly towards the driver, making it more of a driver-centric kind of display. So that is always a plus, and it's kind of nice they shared that with the GTR a little bit. That style, I should say. But up front, you will find an 8-inch colored touchscreen display coming standard with Bluetooth and audio streaming, as well as Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Meaning if you have a smartphone, simply hook it up to the Maxima, therefore you have free navigation through that smartphone, as well as the ability to like and dislike your bin door songs up on that screen as well. If you wanted a factory navigation system, although you don't really need it, it actually comes standard on the SV trim level and up, which is kind of surprising. A lot of other manufacturers will leave that factory navigation to the very top trim levels, but Nissan put it on the SV, so that's kind of cool. Also, I wanted to mention, just on top of that tech display, you have a CD player. How often do you see CD players in cars these days? Almost never. So for everyone watching this video that wants a CD player, you can get one in the Nissan Maxima. It comes standard. There you go. And of course, you can check out your radio settings up on that screen as well. And by the way, when it comes to the sound systems, you will get an 8-speaker sound system with the S or the SV trim levels. However, if you went with the SL trim level and up like we have today, you will get an 11-speaker Bose sound system. So You guys know what we have to do next. Let's go ahead and turn on the radio, see what we got playing today, and let's test out the clarity of this one. Hey, Bose, I always say this, Bose always does an amazing job. One of my favorite sound systems out there, really. Had a Bose sound system on my Infiniti G35. It never ever broke on me throughout the lifetime of owning that vehicle. So definitely a very high quality, ton of bass, crystal clear. Love the Bose sound system in the Maxima, quite honestly. But last thing I wanted to mention to you guys on that tech display is when you do put the Maxima in reverse, you will find a rear view camera coming standard for all trim levels across the board. And if you went with the SR trim level and up, by the way, this is a new feature for the SR, you will get a 360 degree monitor as well, a bird's eye view, if you will. But again, that is one of the new features for the 2020 Maxima, getting that bird's eye view in the SR trim level and up. So that, of course, is going to let you know who or what is behind you and all around you. And that is going to lead us into safety. And so first off, I wanted to mention the Nissan Maxima is an IIHS top safety pick, which is always a good start. Front side curtain airbags will come standard. In addition to that, driver and passenger knee airbags up front. In the back, you're going to have latch, aka lower anchors and tethers for children, for the rear car seats. Also rear child door locks, tire pressure monitoring system, and all trim levels in the Maxima will also give you forward collision warning, automatic emergency braking with pedestrian detection, rear automatic braking, lane departure warning, blind spot monitor with rear cross traffic alert, a rear sonar system, high beam assist, and a driver attention monitor as well. That is a ton of standard safety features for every single trim level. Well done, Nissan, for that. SV trim level and up is going to add to that traffic sign recognition system, as well as adaptive cruise control. And lastly, the SL trim level and up is also going to give you a front sonar system. So those sonar systems being the car is essentially going to beep at you if you get too close to an object so you don't go hitting anything. So that's always a plus. But that is about it for this one, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to follow me on social media at the bottom of the screen there if you like. Be sure to hit the subscribe and the bell notification button if you're in new car reviews. That is what we do here on this channel after all. Do appreciate you guys watching more than you know, and I will see you guys all in the next video. Stay gold.